Hello friends, I am Vijayan Velivari. All are welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video session 10, that is the third video on caution order, we will see what is meant by this long duration work and short duration work. It is essential to know all this, to know what is meant by this CI, SI and TI in the caution order. In the caution order, we have seen three columns where this CI, that is caution indicator, SI speed indicator and TA termination indicators are mentioned. So to complete this subject on caution order, we must know this also. So we can directly go to the diagram. At first let us see what is short duration work. Short duration work is a work which can be completed within a day. Day means sunrise to sunset. So in the morning, if you can see the signals, track, etc. by the sunlight, then it is called sunrise. Short duration work is a work which can be completed within a day, that is from sunrise to sunset, and which will not result in any speed restriction. So our same station, S station, here we have berth route train, let it be there. Then there is the Y station, it is up to which the train is going. That is its destination station. You can see the stations O, P, Q, R, etc. in here. Here this, just this S and T, I have just inflated the distance only for this purpose of this explaining this short duration work. Between station S and T, here there is a level crossing gauge. So this level crossing gauge is at kilometer 472 bar 8 and 10. So now LC gate number 523 is at kilometer 472 bar 8 and 10. Now our station is at kilometer 465 bar 4 and 6, and the distance increases here. Here it is 472 bar 8 and 10, and our T station is at 474 bar 16 and 10. From where you will get this kilometer number? This kilometer number will be obtained from the mast. Wherever this track is electrified, you can see an overhead line for supplying electricity to the loco. On either side of the track, you can see posts erected for supporting this wire. And these posts are, they are called mast. And this mast, the number will be written. The kilometer number will be written. So, 472 bar 8 and 10 means one post it will be written 470 here in this side, a post will be there, it will be written 472 bar 8, and here 472 bar 9, and here again 472 bar 10. So in between this 472 bar 8 and 10, that is in between these two posts, we are having this level crossing gauge. So here we are going to undertake a work, and that is a short duration work. The short duration work which is going to be taken here is opening and examination of the gate. Due to the continuous passage of road vehicle, here below this track, the land will become very hard. Normally, you know, when the train is moving, track will go up and down, and so there will be a cushioning effect. That cushioning effect will be lost here due to the continuous passage of road vehicles. Here there will be ballast below the track, and this ballast below the track will be removed completely, and it will be repacked. After removing the soil, etc., it will be repacked. So that is the opening and examination. This will be undertaken in every LC gate at least once in 3 years. I told in my previous videos that short duration work and long duration work are programmed work. PW has the program to open and examination this LC gate tomorrow. For that he will arrange men and material, and now while doing this work he wanted speed restriction for the train, because the staff will be working, and also underneath the track there will not be ballast for a long period during the work. So he wanted speed restriction at this gate, a 30 km/h speed restriction, 30 km/h. Tomorrow this LC gate cannot be kept opened for road traffic. So civil authorities will be well informed earlier that this particular level crossing gate number 523 will be kept closed for tomorrow. Though this gate is near to T station, SCPUA will give caution order message here at the station S, because station S is controlling or station S is dispatching trains towards this direction. So here SCPUA will give a message to the station master. Next of the message will be like this, from SCPUA to senior DOM, copy to station master S, number SC bar PUA bar 28 bar 1, kindly permit 30 km/h speed restriction at kilometer 472 bar 8 and 10 between station S and station T in upper line at LC gate number 523 for opening and examination of the LC gate. From this time he will also be there, because it is a short duration work, he must mention the time also, from 10 hours to 18 hours. So from 10 hours to 18 hours. On getting this message from SCPUA, the station master will inform controller. He will just communicate this message as such to the controller. Naturally, controller will bring that message to DOM. Now, next day, the permission will be given. So the day, next day means tomorrow, the work is to be undertaken. So morning, the message will be given from the control office that the caution is permitted. What the SCPUA will do? He will come in the morning, or he will send his staff in the morning to the station to see whether it is permitted or not. So station master will give in writing that this speed restriction is permitted. Or staff may bring the earlier message, and in that station master will just write caution permitted. That will be written there. Now the responsibility of the station master. The caution or the speed restriction is from 10 hours to 18 hours of the day. So he has to stop all the trains from 10 hours to issue caution order. He will inform the notice station. Here you will see this is notice station M. So to the notice station M, he will give this message. At what time he will give the message? At any time he can give this message to the station master. Station master S will prepare his own message based upon this SCPUA message, and he will communicate that to station master M, supported by a private number. So the message can be like this. From station master S to station master M, kindly advise all upline GLPs to observe a speed restriction of 30 km/h at kilometer 472 bar 8 and 10 between station S and T at LC gate number 523 for opening and examination of the LC gate from 10 hours to 18 hours. Specifically mentioned that the caution begins or the speed restriction begins at 10 hours. So the station master M will issue caution to the train which may reach this spot at 10 hours. So a train starting from here at 9 hours may reach here at 10 hours. So for this train which is started at 9 hours, he will issue caution order. In that case, the station master M will inform station master S that this is the first train to which he has issued caution order. So while acknowledging this message from station master S, station master M will give the first train to which caution order issued, and also the trains which left before that. Station master S will note down all these things. Station master S will see that all the trains leaving his station after 10 hours is with caution. So first train from station M comes, and if it is run through, it has gone, means after that no run through trains is to be issued with caution order. from the list of provided by the station master M about the trains which left before this first train. For that, he must see, station master S will see that all the train has already left, or if any train is left behind, that should be stopped out of course at the station to issue caution order if it is run through. The trains which are stopping here and stopping out of course at the station, yes, the station master will issue major caution order in T bar B 409. But if he can ensure from the loco pilot through VHF that he is having the caution, this particular LC gate caution, 30 km/h caution he has received from station M, from notice station, it is available with him, then he need not issue remainder caution order. In certain railways it is implemented. So let us see what is happening at this LC gate. LC gate workers will be digging out the mud and ballast underneath this track, and at that time, and nowadays they are using machine also to complete the work within one day. They are using SCPV will use machine also. So when the work is going on, a train may come, and that train must invariably be stopped. When it is safe to go at 30 km/h, then only the train should be allowed. So when the work is going on, the staff will be working, workers will be working continuously, and even the track may be sometimes bent and all. So the trains, if at all coming, it must be stopped. It can be allowed to pass at 30 km/h only when it is safe to pass here. So first the train must be stopped. So now let us see what is the arrangement made here by the SCPV for this passage of the train. From the caution spot is here in the LC gate where the work is going on. From there, 1200 meters away, here a staff will be standing here with a red flag. That is, we can say stop hand signal. And also here he will place 3 detonators at 10 meters apart. You know the track normally, it will be having 2 rails, is it not? So at 10 meters apart means 1 detonator will be placed here, then 10 meters apart 1 detonator, then 10 meters apart 1 detonator here. The detonators will be placed like this on the rail. So now let us see what is a detonator. Detonator is an explosive device, or we can say it is an audible signal used in railways, and it is having a red top and also 2 clasps. These clasps are used to keep the detonator firmly on the rail. So these detonators are used to warn the loco pilot. When the train passes over this rail, the detonator will explode with a loud noise, and that loud noise will attract the attention of the loco pilot. That is the intention. So it is an explosive device, an audible signal used in railways to attract the attention of the loco pilot. The explosive device, when it is burst, there will be serious shattering from it. So when the detonator is placed, the staff should stand 45 meters away from this detonator. So 3 detonators are placed, 1, 2, and 3, at 10 meters apart, and this staff will stand 45 meters away with the stop hand signal. He must show to the train this red flag and stop the train. The train will come and stop before this detonator. Now 600 meters from the LC gate, there will be another staff standing with stop hand signal in his hand, and here a banner flag will be placed. What is a banner flag? Banner flag is a red cloth actually with 1.5 meter length and 45 centimeter width, and it is supported by 2 poles, and this is called a temporary danger signal. So it is a temporary danger signal. It will be placed across the track. Here also we can see trackman will be standing with a red flag. Now here is the LC gate. From here, 30 meters away from that gate, another staff, another trackman will be standing with the red flag in his hand. This is how the arrangement is made for protecting this caution spot and also the staff working there. Now let us see how this arrangement works when the train comes. So the train is already issued with the caution order from station S, and the loco pilot will be very cautious. He will be given the kilometer 472 bar 8 and 10 etc. So in approaching this kilometer, loco pilot will be very cautious. See, 1.2 kilometer away from this caution spot, he can see the staff showing the stop hand signal. So the loco pilot will come and stop here. After removing these detonators, the staff, the trackman will give, proceed with the caution signal to the loco pilot. Proceed with the caution signal is given with the green flag. It will be vertically moving up and down. So the train will move. The train will move and it will come and stop at this banner flag. Here also trackman is there with the stop hand signal. Banner flag is also there. He will come and stop here. So on seeing this train, SCPA will see that the workers working at this area, they are moved away to safety, and also track is also fit for running the train at a 30 kmph. Then he will tell this trackman to give signal to this trackman. And here this trackman immediately remove this banner flag and give proceed with the caution signal to the train. And here this trackman also will show proceed with the caution signal to the loco pilot. The train will move and cross this level crossing at a speed of 30 kmph. And after passing this level crossing gate, the guard will give all right signal to the loco pilot, and loco pilot will pick up speed and he will move with normal speed. This is how the trains are operated in this short duration work. Now the SCPA has completed his work before 18 hours itself. That is, by 16 hours he completed the work. Now he can cancel the caution so that the trains can be moved at a normal speed. So what he will do? He will withdraw the staff from here or from all these spots, and he will come to the station S, and he will issue a cancellation message to the station master S. The cancellation message can be like this: from SCPA to the station master S. Here also a number will be quoted, a number SCPA bar 28 bar 2 he can give, and he will say, cancel my message number SC bar PVA bar 28 bar 1 from 16 hours date. So that will be the single line message he will be giving to the station master S. Station master S will paste that message in the caution order message book where he pasted the earlier message. And also on the by the side of it, he will write in red ink, giving the date, time, the caution cancelled at 16 hours. He will communicate the cancellation message to station master M and also the controller. And this message can be in his own words, that is, from station master S to station master M, cancel my message number so and so. Earlier he will give a message within the number, so he will say, cancel my message number so and so from 16 hours. Here the station master M will note it down, and also they will exchange PN. Though exchange of PN is not mentioned in the GR and SR, here the PN will be exchanged between station master M and S. And also he will communicate, station master S will communicate the same message to controller, and here also PN will be exchanged. Now the station master M, on getting this message, he will write it in the caution message register and also caution order register. In both registers, he will write it and cancel the caution. Thereafter, he will not issue caution order to any uptrain moving from station M. The trains which have left the station M before 16 hours will be having this caution order. What will happen to these trains? These trains, it will go on, there is no staff to stop it, they will proceed and naturally with 30 kmph, and they will observe that caution and go. This is how the cancellation of the caution is practiced. I could complete only the short duration work in this video. Now itself it is about 20 minutes length. So we will complete our caution order in the next video, in which we will see how this long duration work is undertaken and what this caution indicator, speed indicator and termination indicator, etc. Those who are yet to subscribe this channel, kindly subscribe and also click the bell icon near that subscription button, so that you will be getting the notification about the new video whenever it is posted in YouTube. Also, please share this video with your friends. Of course, it may be a little difficult for ordinary people to follow what is told in this caution order, etc. Anyhow, after the completion of this caution order, we will start our train and we will continue our journey. And there we will see how the failures are managed. Okay, we will see in our next video.